So in this Blender tutorial, I am going to go over the basics of how to use the line art modifier on a still render in Blender. Press the number pad 0 to see your camera view. You have to have a camera in position before you start adding line art with the modifier, because Blender is going to draw the line art from the perspective of your active camera. But you can always move the camera later and it will recalculate the lines. Your first thought might be to click the object and look in the modifier tab for the line art modifier, but you won't find it there. You see, the line art modifier is a grease pencil modifier. Grease pencil is the 2D drawing system built into Blender, so we need to have what's called a stroke in our scene as well. A stroke, like a stroke from a paintbrush, is a type of object in grease pencil. In object mode, press Shift A to add a new object. In the list of options, go down to grease pencil and then select stroke. This squiggly new object is our stroke. This is actually the object we are going to add the modifier to. The modifier is going to make this stroke project over whatever object or collection we tell it to, from the perspective of the camera. You can move this stroke out of your view, but with it selected, go to the modifiers tab. These are the modifiers available to strokes. Different object types, like strokes, have different modifiers that can be applied. Here in the generate column, you can see line art. Select the line art modifier to add it. There are two areas of information you have to give the modifier before you can actually see the line art. The first is this source information up at the top. The second is the target information a little further down. The source information is what you want the line art to appear on. You can select object to choose a specific object, a collection to choose all objects within that collection, or you can select scene and it will add the line art uniformly across the entire scene. But you may not want to do that because you're going to lose some control. See, in scenes, you might want to have thicker lines in some areas, thinner lines in other areas. So I'm going to select object to start with. Then I'm going to select the car model. The target information is what you want from the grease pencil stroke projected as line art. So strokes now have two default layers named colors and lines. Although it doesn't seem to matter which one you choose, under target layer, let's choose lines. Under target material, you will see some default colored materials to choose from. This will be the color of your line art. You can change these or add more in the materials properties of the stroke object. I will be choosing black. So now the line art appears, simple as that. Let's go back up just a little in the settings and discuss edge types. These checkboxes give you control over which types of edges the line art will display on. Contour at the top is for your major outlines of the object. Creases at the bottom are anywhere your object's geometry changes direction. When that's checked, you'll be given a crease threshold slider displaying an angle in degrees. So anything with an angle smaller than this angle will be considered a crease and will have line art displayed. It defaults to 140 degrees. If I slide the crease threshold all the way to 180, it draws a line on every angled crease. As I move it slowly downward, fewer and fewer lines fall under this threshold, so fewer lines are actually drawn. The intersections box is to add line art where two objects intersect. Material borders will draw lines where there's a change in materials. This is pretty helpful. And edge marks is a useful way to manually mark lines you want drawn. If there is a specific line on your 3D object where you want to generate the line art, go into edit mode, select the line and press Ctrl E, or go to your edge menu, select Mark Freestyle Edge, and the selected edges will be drawn. Under the style settings, you can change the thickness and transparency of your strokes. There are a few more settings below I haven't noticed make a huge difference yet, but I do see that you can choose instanced objects, and that is supposed to include particle system objects in the line art, which is pretty cool. Now, when you move around your scene, you'll notice that the line art only appears on what's visible from the camera. That's why the camera being in place is so important. Now let me open up this scene and I'll show you how I used a few different modifiers on different objects. I wanted thicker lines for the buildings, fairly thin lines for the people and cars, and something in the middle for the sidewalks and other things. So I grouped the objects into collections based on how thick I wanted the line art on those objects. I then created a single stroke object, but added three modifiers to it. In the source information for each object, I selected collection, and I pointed each modifier to a different collection. What I didn't do, but I realized I could have later, was to have multiple line art modifiers point to the same collection. I could then have one modifier control the contour lines, maybe making them a little bit thicker. I could then have another modifier only apply to creases and make them thinner for more variety and detail. The more modifiers you use, the more control you'll have over how each group of line art looks. One thing I noticed is that the line art modifier seemed to really slow down my computer, so I kept the viewport visibility turned off for most of my project. By the way, I ended up throwing this render onto a t-shirt, and I have it listed on Amazon for $20. If you want to support a fellow artist, there's a link in the description.